Ugh. Well, this opening hand is not great, but we're gonna keep. Like, this card is good. Mechanic Minotaurs aren't bad. Like, I do like a Hill Giant in general. They're just kind of bad in this format. But not, like, so bad that I'm upset that they're in my deck or anything. Hope I draw a 2-drop here, but whatever. If he doesn't do anything too aggressive, I don't care that much, though. We didn't know his other color was red. Now this guy just becomes quite bad. Oh, his own young Pyromancer. Well, I feel like this game is going to be just like the last one, but reversed. Yeah, wow, this card is incredibly bad right now. I'm not even positive I can side it out. I guess I can leave in the hatchling. The 3/4 is pretty bad too. Yeah, it says like any spell here gets to trade a 1/1 for this, like if he has like an instant. Alright, yeah, so probably sided in the hatchling and just. Alright, well. I think he has a bump spell, but going to block because I can't really wait to cast my pump spell, like, I only have a 4 drop, yeah. Saw that coming, but what can you do? He has another guy too. Okay. That I don't care that much about. And we're not the worst shape now, because we can like Minotaur, then like Minotaur and have Giant Growth up next turn. And then next turn we can cast the Spore guy and just play lands after. I mean, all these 1/1s are gonna get actually pretty annoying slash pretty good against me, but I guess I do have the troll hide to mitigate that. Now let's see if he all right. Like, you could play around me having the giant growth, but. Now, what do I get blown out by? Chandra's Outrage? I just can't leave this up next turn, is kind of the problem. Because of Spore Monger. If I could leave this up next turn, I would just cast, or would not cast it, but as is, I think I kind of have to. I guess he kind of saw it coming, like he'd rather leave the root wall and play. Though, now I can like trade Canny Minotaur and like a Spore Monger token for root wall, which is fine. That card's annoying. Can also just chump it for a turn at least with one of these tokens. Till I get a troll hide up and running. Probably better than trading right there. Guess probably on troll hide this, because it's the thing we care most about living. Like, I don't know, let's see if he leaves mana up, because the other thing is. We care most about living, so we don't want to get blown out by like a outrage in response. I mean, he would have had to draw it. He obviously didn't have an outrage last turn, but that doesn't give him trample, right? It's a 6/6. Okay. Of course, till that gets out of the way, we're not even. Trolley's not even doing anything for us. Might even just wait on casting it. Well, buddy Oren just texted me that he's 4-2 in the moto PTQ that's going on right now. That's not great. I assume that's out of contention. Been a while since I played a Moto PTQ, but I know they have like 700 people in them. Yeah, I don't know. I could have cast that. It's just like it doesn't do anything right now. Like, it's pretty awkward. Like, I want to get a guy that's big enough to like rumble through this. Like one of my 4/4s. Or draw like another pump spell would be fine too. Well, the Spore guy has been pretty sweet in the long game. I guess maybe next game I do just want Howl of the Night pack. Like, I don't know if making a bunch of 2/2/0 would even do that much. Though, maybe the 7 drop thing is reasonable here. Killing on Pyromancer. Alright, so who's got? Ugh. Well, now I feel stupid for not troll hiding that. Also, kind of was hoping that had the weak wood table, but man, I have so many lands and nowhere to go. Right, well, guess gotta do what gotta do. Man, yeah, if I had troll out of that, it's just I get at least two more guys, probably more as the game goes. I don't even know that I have anything like too insane that I can draw here that I mean, I guess the 3/4 guy would be fine. Don't know how much that does for him, unless I guess he's planning attacking everything next turn. Yeah, I definitely don't think I want the Law of Axes against him. I mean, seems like what's gonna be important in this match is just like board superiority. We have very similar decks. Ugh. Not that it really buys them even all that much, I guess, but attack and I can. Well, I mean, I have to attack for more than one thing for these, not just bounce off each other and be kind of irrelevant. It's not like tying up my mana does anything. He's got something else. Like lightning talons or something? Ratchet Bomb. Well, that's probably gonna be pretty annoying. Just get that up to 4, right? No, just get rid of all my 1/1s. Okay. Well, it certainly simplified the battlefield for us. Alright, so. Well, I have to block at least one of these. If I double block this sliver and trade with it, then I take 13 going to 1. Now I need to draw two guys to actually not just die, which seems suboptimal. These bouncing and like trading this guy and me taking 11 puts me to 3. But then I'm not dead if I draw a guy, which I guess is a little better. Well, I'll go to blockers. So yeah, I don't think I can trade for this. I would really basically need to draw like I don't even flames wouldn't do it. Alright, yeah. I think I need to like alright, well I can do this. This. Then he has to regenerate. In which case, if I draw flames, it actually kills this, which seems pretty good. Alright. We'll go with that. I guess also shot kills it then, too. Probably about the best we can do. Draw another troll hide would be okay. That's also fine. Yeah, I guess him not being able to pump is pretty helpful. Because I was doing my math basing this on a 4-4. Alright, well, same problem as last turn, basically. Well, I don't need to block this, I can just go to 1. I want to be able to kill this. Now, if I block these two, this dies. I don't think there's any way I don't lose both these guys, what I'm trying to figure out. I guess if I block here, here. No, there's like no way. So, might as well block on that such that he also has to regenerate. I'm dead to a pump spell, dead to a shock, kind of whatever. Alright. Well, we get to live a turn. And actually, it's not particularly beneficial to him to keep attacking. Because I basically get to trade the worm for the root wall if he attacks, because I'll just chump here and then block here. But he has to attack with at least this, so. I don't know. Don't know what it'll do, but this is essentially going to be chump blocking if he attacks with both. Mutavault, jeez. I mean, I guess that's the same as any creature at this point. It's just a creature's gonna be annoying. Says how many regeneration shields are on a guy. That's weird. All right. Well. We're dead, but I guess we'll make sure he actually attacks us with everything, because might not. Could have a shock, though there's not any punishment for him attacking with everything, really. So I can't crack back for the win or anything. Get to see another card in his deck. Yeah, okay. So he has multiple troll hides, which might be good enough for me to want the naturalize. Alright, well, these cards are just basically unplayable. Getting pretty low on creatures at this point. I think this is probably fine. Also, we might want to naturalize. Troll, it's pretty freaking annoying. It's kind of a big blowout if I can naturalize one of them. And it could side in one more forest. It's getting a little bit greedy, but I don't have that many double red spells. Games go long, do want a lot of forests. Alright, we'll see what happens here.